55 students are there. So actually, some 63 students are there in the sixth semester and 70 students are there in the fourth semester. So totally, we have only 56 students. So you might be knowing, no? HODs are daily conducting the counseling for students. So HOD sir will ask me to send the attendance of the placement also, placement activities. So if you people are going to become absent means definitely you should give the answer to the HOD while HOD sir conducting the counseling for you students. Okay, please inform your friends to attend the activities. Okay. Okay. So we'll start. So good afternoon to all. So once again, we are creating a platform to combine all semester students of our department. Okay. So today we'll start the placement activities for the E1 semester 2021. And I have prepared the activities list. Okay, I'll share the activities list in the Google Classroom for you people. And a few of the activities are repeated in the list. I have prepared the list, no, placement activities list. So many of the activities are repeated here. That means last semester we had conducted activities like problems on numbers, distance calculation, speed distance calculation, and problems on blood relationship. And so like that, some of the activities are repeated here. Okay, so I asked many of your seniors, that is 8th semester students, about these activities. So I just asked like what are all the different activities that we may conduct for you people. Okay, you are saying 8th semester students, your seniors, they told for the same activities they will prepare for the campus placements. So campus placements again to prepare after na. The same activities what we have prepared in the list, no? At this moment I have prepared the list. So for the same topics they are going to prepare for the campus placements. Okay, so the list I have prepared, it is definitely help you people to get prepared for the campus placements. Okay, at least the basic things definitely you will get. Okay, and one thing I want to share here before starting the activities, before starting the session. So our 8th semester students, 32 students, their strength is 58, 8th semester students, your senior strength. So out of 58, 32 students have got placed in different companies. Okay, so that information I want to share. Wait. I have shared the screen. Once again, it is Excel sheet. It is not visible, no? I think it is, now it is shared. It is visible, no? See here. So here I have the list of names of your 8th semester students, of our 8th semester students. So totally 32 students have got placed in different companies out of 58 till now. Okay, still many campus drives are happening in the campus. Okay, so out of 32, many students they got selected for more than one companies. See here, Vinanti, she is your senior, she got selected in two companies, Stavta Solutions and TCS. Okay, similarly Raghavendra, you might be knowing this senior. Okay, he got selected for three companies, SLK, Pinclick and Subex. Okay, and one more thing he was telling yesterday. So he attended the campus interview for which company? Accenture. He cleared the first round, he cleared the second round, third round, fourth round. In order to clear all these four rounds, he took 15 days. Okay. In the fourth round, that is HR round, that happens through online mode, no? So 2 days back it has happened, I think he told like. So in HR round, first he asked, they told, tell me about yourself like that. So Raghavendra, he told, yes, I am the 8th semester student from Department of Information Science and Engineering, GMIT. Atara helidane. Takshana avaru interview maartiravaru, oh, you are still studying anta kelidare. Who, how do sir anta? No, sorry, actually we want 2020 outgoing batch students, not the current students anta. Atara heli avaru interview stop maadidare. Andre ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ಅವನು ನಾಲ್ಕು ಮೂರು ಕಂಪ್ನಿ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದಾನೆ, ಎಸ್ ಎಲ್ ಕೆ, ಪಿನ್ಕ್ಲಿಕ್, ಸುಬೆಕ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೈನ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಹಿ ರೀಚ್ಡ್ ಫೈನಲ್ ರೌಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಂಚರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಕಂಪನಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರು ಇನ್ನ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಇದ್ದಾನೆ, 8th ಸೆಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಇದ್ದಾನೆ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಿ ಅವರು ಫೋರ್ತ್ ರೌಂಡ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ರೌಂಡ್, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ರೌಂಡ್, ಥರ್ಡ್, ಫೋರ್ತ್ ರೌಂಡ್ ತನಕನು ಹೋಗಿದ್ದಾನೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೋರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ಒನ್ ಕಂಪನೀಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನೀವು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಆದರೆ, ನಿಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಇತ್ತು ಅಂದರೆ ಬೇಗ ಕಂಪ್ನಿಗೆ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆಗ್ತೀರಿ, ಮತ್ತು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕಂಪ್ನಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆಗ್ತೀರಿ. ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕಂಪ್ನಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆದರೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಯಾವ್ದು ಇಷ್ಟ ಇರುತ್ತೋ ಆ ಕಂಪ್ನಿ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ಬೋದು. ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ಅವರ್ ಟೈಮ್. ಸೊ ಟುಡೇ ದ ಸೆಷನ್, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್. So today's session will be handled by Arushi, fourth semester. She is going to discuss about the basics of C programming. She has cleared NPTEL course, no, in programming, C programming subject. So the same assignment, problems and programs she is going to discuss now. Okay, I'll hand over the session to Arushi now. Arushi?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, you are ready now, Arushi?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. You can start now. You are going to share the screen now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Is my slides visible, ma'am?
Yes, visible.
Good afternoon.
Arushi, first introduce yourself and then you can stand.
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Arushi, from 4th sem. Today, I would like to discuss problems based on programming in C. First problem, which one of the following statement is the most appropriate?
Flowchart.
Yes, ma'am.
F5 could slide. F5 present as in the slides.
Yes, ma'am. Diagrammatic representation of the algorithm. Pseudocode is just another name of algorithm. Flowchart is basically a diagrammatic representation of the algorithm, whereas in pseudocode, normal English language is translated into the programming language to be worked on. Option C, pseudocode is basically a diagrammatic representation of the algorithm, whereas in flowchart, normal English language is translated into the programming language to be worked on. Option D, pseudocode is another name of programming, whereas in flowchart is a diagrammatic representation of algorithm. Answer is option B, flowchart is basically a diagrammatic representation of the algorithm, whereas in pseudocode, normal English language is translated into the programming language to be worked on. Second question, when we write x is equal to 10 and y is equal to x, which of the following memory assignment is correct? Option A, x and y will have same locations and 10 will be stored. X and y will have two distinct locations and 10 will be stored in both. Option C, or X and Y will have same locations and only X will contain value 10. In option D, X and Y will have two distinct locations and only X will contain value 10. Correct answer is option B, that is x and y will have two distinct locations and 10 will be stored in both. Because y here assignment operation is there, that is y is equal to x. Next question, if input from the user is 6, the output of the following algorithm will be. They have given a flowchart in which we have to print the value of x. Here we have to read the value of n, that is 6. Initial condition is I is equal to 1 and x is equal to 1. It will check a condition where I is less than n, that is 1 is less than 6. The condition will be equated and it is true. So it will execute I is equal to I plus 1. Here I is incremented, so now the new value of I is 2. Then x is equal to x into I. The new value of I is 2 and the x value is 1. So x, the new value of x is 2. And now again the condition will be checked, that is I less than n, that is 2 is less than n. 2 is less than 6, the condition becomes true. Then I is incremented, so I is equal to 3. So the value x is equal to x into I, that is x is 2 and I is 2. X is new value is x is 2 and I is equal to 3. So x is equal to 6. Now again I value will be checked. I is less than n, that is 3 is less than 6. Condition becomes true and I is incremented. The new value of I is updated to 4 and x is equal to previous value of x is 6 into 4. So it will again, the new value of x will be 24. Now again I will be checked with n, whether it is less than n, that is I is 4 is less than 6, so I is incremented to 5. Then 5 is multiplied with 24, answer will be 120. Again I will be incremented, I will be equal to 5, I will be 5 and I will be incremented to 6. 6 is multiplied with 120, x will be 720. Now I is 6, so I is not less than 6, it is equal to 6, it will, the condition fails and we will print the value of x, that is 720.
Okay, Arushi. See here, don't link the meter. Okay, so 75 students were there. 2 students left the meter. I'll get the details from once I upload the attendance sheets, no? So definitely I can find out who those 2 students left out, no? So I can find out their names. Don't leave the meeting. Okay. And see here, in this problem, so they have given the algorithm, okay. So, and they are telling that user will give the input 6 for the value n. So, for the variable n, the 6 is given as input. So, finally, they are asking what is the output of the algorithm. So, from this flowchart, what is the output? So, here it is just like a loop. So we are repeating these instructions. Repeatedly we are executing these instructions. Okay, by taking the initial value of I is equal to 1 and x value is 1. So for every iteration of the loop, we are checking this condition. So I is less than n or not. So as long as I is less than n, so the loop will be repeated. So every time we are going to repeat the loop, no? So I value will be incremented by 1. And x value will be incremented. How it is x value is incremented?
X is, yes, not incremented, ma'am.
No, not Arushi, other students. See, I value is incremented by 1. I is equal to I plus 1 they have given. How the x value is incremented here?
x is equal to x into i.
X for every iteration of the for loop, x is multiplied by the new value of I. So the new value of x is stored in the x by deleting its previous value. Okay, so this will be repeated here. You must know the flowchart symbols and all. So these arrow marks means, so we are repeating the loop. Okay, so we are repeating the execution of the loop. So once the I become greater than n or I become equal to n, so we will come out of the loop. So finally we will print the value of x. Okay, so it is one of the NPTEL question asked in NPTEL course assignmental kelirontadu. Arushi, you can continue.
Yes. Next question, what is the output of the following program? They have defined a function here, x star x, next, and I is of float, I is equal to 64.0 divided by function of 2. For this operation function, it will call the function, that is 2 will be passed for this function. 2 into 2, we will get 4. 64.0 by 4, we will get 16 as the answer. 16, since they have asked to print the value of I with the 2 decimal places, it will be 16.00. Ma'am.
Okay.
This program. Yeah.
Yes, Arushi.
Can I execute this program?
Before that, you can execute this one. Just I'll ask some of the students. Anybody can explain this? Can repeat the explanation of the same program? It is a little bit different. Yes, please. Other students. Abhinandan. Abhinandan, see that program.
Ma'am,
We
are using a function, ma'am. In the function, we are going to multiply the same number.
In the functions, we are going to multiply the same thing.
Same number, ma'am. Like if x is 2, means we are going to multiply 2 with 2.
Abhinandan, see this, how they have defined the function. So function definition is, syntax is little bit different, no?
Yes, ma'am.
How it is? Function return type is not there, okay. Parenthesis, yes, it is a function. They have passed the parameter x. Where is the body of the function? Function should have the definition, body iratte. So we enclose all the instructions inside the opening and closing brace, no? Here, there is no body of the function. Like that, it is visible. None function atara can't be there. You just clear that to other students. Okay, it's okay, Abhinandan. Some other student. Our seniors. Diksha,
yes ma'am.
Diksha beda, elladuku diksha diksha antane heltirthini, avu baikolad beda nanna.
No ma'am.
Chandrika, yes Chandrika. Chandrika, there is a network problem. She left the meeting. I think it is not intentional. I think network problem is created. Okay, let me check. Let me ask. Yes, Amrut. Amrut, where are you? Aishwarya. Eli.
Yes, ma'am.
Please, can you explain this program, Aishwarya?
Adu macros, ma'am, use madradate. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವೇನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಪಾಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಇಂಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಬಂದು ಇಲ್ಲಿ 64 ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದಟ್ ಸಮ್ ವಾಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಪ್ರಿಂಟ್ ಎಫ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಲೀವಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಫ್ಲೋಟ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್ ನ ಅದು ಪ್ರಿಂಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ.
ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಸಮ್ ಫ್ಯೂ ದಿಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ರೋಸ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಅವರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ರೋಸ್. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸಿ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯೂಶಲಿ ನಮ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಸೆಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಸಿ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಕಲ್ತಿರೋದು ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಕೆನ್ ಯು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ರೋಸ್, 2-3 ಲೈನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್, ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ರೋ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್. ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕೇಳ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಐಶ್ವರ್ಯ ನಂಗೆ.
ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಈಗ ಅನ್ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡೆ. ಅದು ಪ್ರೀ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸರ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ಅದು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹಂಗೆ ಇನ್ ಡೆಫಿನಿಷನ್ ನನಗೆ ನೆನಪಿಲ್ಲ, ಬಟ್ ಅದನ್ನ ಸಿಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ನೋಡಿ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ರೋಸ್ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು.
ಓಕೆ, ಆರುಷಿ.
ಯೆಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ದಿಸ್, ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ರೋ?
ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
Then how you identified this as a how this program execution takes place, how do you identify this?
They have defined the function in by hash define. No ma'am.
Okay, so we got really a good topic. So next time, next placement activity, we discuss about the macros only. Okay, we'll see that, because in Aishwarya kelde, ಆರುಷಿ ಕೇಳಿದೆ, ಅಮೃತ್, ಅಭಿಷೇಕ್, ಅಭಿನಂದನ್, ಸೊ ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ಮಚ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ರೋಸ್ ನೋ. ಸೊ ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ ಒನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್, ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ರೋಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ. ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ಆರುಷಿ, ದ ಮೇನ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವೆರಿ ಈಸಿಲಿ. ವಿ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ನೋ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ನೋ. ಸೊ ಓಕೆ, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಶೋ ದ ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ನೌ.
ಓಕೆ. We'll get 16 as the answer.
F5, press F5 Arushi.
Yes ma'am. Next question, the following C program converts the temperature from Celsius to Fahrenheit. Fill the blanks with the proper formula to do it. Here they have given a program and they have asked to fill a space to run to convert the temperatures from Celsius to Fahrenheit. They have given value of Celsius, that is 37.5, and we have to write a formula here to convert Celsius to Fahrenheit, and we have to print the value of Fahrenheit. For this we know the formula, that is 9/5 into C plus 32 to convert from Celsius to Fahrenheit. So answer is A, where 9/5 is 1.8. Next question.
Vinay, fourth semester. Vinay, what is this printf statement? The control string percentage dot 2f. You just tell me about this printf.
After the number, after we get 1.8, ma'am, that is float value, ma'am. After the decimal 2 0 0
two digits,
Yes, ma'am.
We have to consider after the decimal point,
after
two digits
decimal
we have
point.
To consider.
Two digits we get, ma'am.
Okay. Actually, there is a problem with my laptop. So, now you mathaadthiru, the students mathaadthiru, sariye kelisoda illa. Okay, Arushi, you can continue.
Sixth question, what is the output of the following program? In main, int I, if I is equal to 0, 2, 3, printf NPTEL, else printf programming on C. Then we have to print the value of I. For this, I here for in if statement, I will be assigned to 0. So it will print NPTEL. And it will not print programming on C because there is no condition statement here. It is assigned while executing the if statement. So I value will be 0 and it will print as NPTEL 0.
I value is not initialized, no?
Ma'am, it is initialized inside the if statement, ma'am.
Okay, so initially in the first line they have declared, but inside the if block they have initialized it to 0. Okay, only the first initialization.
Ma'am, I have to execute, ma'am.
No, it's okay. You can continue with the next program because we know the output, no? And we can trace the output, no problem.
Okay. Next question. Find the output of the following C code. Here they have given a C program where A is equal to 12, B is equal to 18, C is equal to 7, and D is equal to 4. And result is of integer data type. Result is equal to A plus A star minus B by C modulus D plus C star D. We have to print the result of this expression. If to solve this expression, we have to consider associativity and precedence. If we assign the values of A, B, C, and D, we will get this expression. Multiplication, division, modulus has got highest precedence than addition and subtraction, and the associativity is from left to right. So 12 is multiplied with 18, we will get 216. And then we have to divide it by 7. We will get 30. And 30 modulus 4 is 2. 12 minus 2 plus 7 star 4. 7 is multiplied by 4. So we will get 28. And 12 minus 2 is 10. 10 plus 28 is 38. So answer is 38. Next question, what is the output of the following C code? Here they have assigned y is equal to 10 and int z is equal to y plus y is equal to 10. Here is y is equal to 10. This statement is equal is checked for condition that is equal to 10, which will be equal to 1. So this condition will become true and it is equal to 1. So y is 10, 10 plus 1 is 11. So we will print the z value as 11. Next question, what is the output of the C program given below?
Arushi, once again, come back to the previous program.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Anish, Jain. Anish? Okay, he's not there. Mm. once again. Darshan, simply they have joined the meeting. Gautami, Gautami, is Habiba?
Yes, ma'am.
So can you explain that second instruction, in z is equal to y plus something is there, no?
Actually, I also didn't get why it got one.
Yes, yes, Habiba.
I didn't understand, ma'am, why y equal to 10, it replaces to 1.
Okay, let me ask some other student. Okay, you can mute yourself, no problem. Yes, Divya.
Yes, ma'am.
See that Habiba is having doubt. Why is equal to 10? How that second instruction will be executed? And what value will be assigned to Z?
Ma'am, first 10 is assigned to Y in first line. So Y equal to 10 means Y is equal to 10, which is true. So true means 1. So Z equal to Y plus 1. Y is 10, 10 plus 1 is 11.
Okay. So you are in the first instruction, Y is assigned with the value 10. In the second instruction, inside the parenthesis, we are comparing Y with 10. So Y is equal to 10. It is a comparison operator, double is equal to. Yes, it is true, because initially we have assigned Y value with 10. 10 is equal to 10. True means it is 1. Boolean value true means it is 1. So this comparison expression, it returns 1. So Z is equal to Y plus 1. So previous value of Y is 10. 10 plus 1 is 11. You are going to print that. Habiba, you understood this?
Yes, ma'am.
When Arushi was explaining this?
She explained some little bit fast.
She is your best friend, no? You have to be here.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. You can continue, Arushi.
Yes. Next question. What is the output of C program given below? Int main.
Arushi, wait. Let others to explain this program.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, our Indu is there. Indu?
Yes, ma'am.
How are you, Indu?
Fine, ma'am.
You are sitting in your office, no?
No, ma'am. Then thoda mama nek bandhi.
Okay. Just go through these instructions one by one. You should get the answer B.
Okay, ma'am. First, they are given that int x is equal to 0. If x, that is increment x plus plus, so x is equal to 1. If x is equal to 1, print true. Else, if x is equal to 1, false. So false will be print, I think.
Yeah, analyze it. See the post increment, pre increment. There is a difference.
Post increment. Okay. It will print true.
Arushi has written the answer. Answer is B. According to Arushi, it is
B. Okay. Ma'am, I can't get this.
Okay, actually, I think you are really good in programming, but at this moment, you are not getting the answer. No problem, Indu. I'll go to the Jansi. Jansi, madam. Jansi. Okay. Kalesh. Chance
ಹಾ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು ಮ್ಯಾಮ್. ಅದು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಜೀರೋ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಬಟ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಜೀರೋ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಟ್ರೂ ಪ್ರಿಂಟ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಆ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಜೀರೋ ಒನ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟಿಗೆ ಹೋದಾಗ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಒನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಂಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ.
ಯೆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಇಫ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರಿಮೆಂಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ನೋ, ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರಿಮೆಂಟ್. ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರಿಮೆಂಟ್, ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್. ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಝೀರೋ. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಝೀರೋ, ಇಫ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರಿಮೆಂಟ್, ನೋ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ರಿಮೆಂಟೆಡ್, ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಒನ್, ಸೊ ಎಲ್ಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪ್ರಿಂಟ್ ದ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ ಆರುಷಿ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್.
ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್, ವಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಗಿವನ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್? ಇಂಟ್ ಎ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಒನ್, ಬಿ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಟು, ಸಿ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ತ್ರೀ. ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಚೆಕ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಫ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಿ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ಎ. ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ ಸಿ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಆಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಪರೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎ ಆಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಪರೆಂಟ್. ಸಿ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಈಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ಟು, ವಿಚ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಒನ್, ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಟ್ರೂ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಒನ್, ಒನ್ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ಒನ್ is false, so it will not print true, it will print false, so answer is false.
Okay Arushi, once you go to the next question, no, give others to time, some 30 seconds, let them to think. If they give the answer and you, if they are ready to explain, means you allow them to explain. Okay, before you start explaining, you just ask others to just go through the instructions so that they will think. Otherwise they will keep holding, that's it, they will be in meeting and they will not concentrate here.
Okay ma'am.
Yeah.
Next question, what will be the output of the following function? They have given float a is equal to 6 and we have to print the value of this expression.
Yes, anybody can analyze? Just, she has got the answer D. How it came 17.00? It is very simple, I think. Our 4-semester students can explain this. This 6th semester student is there, Purnima. ಪೂರ್ಣಿಮಾ ಸಂಕನಗೌಡ ಪಾಟೀಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಶಿ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದೇರ್. ಎಸ್ ರಂಜಿತಾ, ಸಿ ರಿಯಲಿ ಐ ಆಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್. ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ಲಿ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಕಾಲಿಂಗ್ ದ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ದ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸ್. Okay, Simran.
Yes, ma'am.
Just go through the instructions one by one. Just try to analyze the instructions.
First, they assign float value A is equal to 6.0. Then there is an operation 9/5 into A plus 11. After doing the operation, we will get in the value 7.0, ma'am. Float will be after 2 feet.
Try to evaluate 9/5, how much? And that 9/5 result into A, what is the value of A? And that result is added with 11. So like that you try to analyze.
and printing format is there. Percentage point 2f is there, not f.
After two digits, it will print the
float. That is okay. What about this expression, arithmetic expression? Okay, some other student. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾರು ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಈ ಸಿಮ್ರನ್ಗೆ ಇದು ಹೇಳಕ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಖಂಡಿತ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್, ಶಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಇವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಯೇಟ್ ದಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್. ಬಟ್ ಯು ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟಿಂಗ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್, ನೀವು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ. ನಾನು ರಂಜಿತಾ ಮಾತಾಡ್ಸಿದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಚಂದ್ರಿಕಾ ಮಾತಾಡ್ಸಿದ್ರೆ ಅವ್ರ ಮೀಟಿಂಗಿಂದ ಲೆಫ್ಟೇ ಆಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಲು. Okay, Arushi.
Yes, ma'am. Here we have to divide 9 by 5, which is equal to 1.8. Since they have given 9 by 5, that is, first print is also integer and the second is also integer, we will not consider 0.8. We will just consider 1 into a, that is 1 into 6. 1 into 6 means 6 plus 11, which is equal to 17, which is then typecasted to float, that is 17.00.
So she used the word called typecasting. Okay, you should know what is type casting, what is type conversion, how the one data type is converted into other data type explicitly, or how the one data type is converted into other data type implicitly. So these things you might be knowing. Okay, yeah, so you must know all these things. Okay, Arush, next.
Next question. Choose the correct output of the following C code. They have given a program. Integer variable 1 is equal to 10, variable 2 is equal to 6. If variable 1 is equal to 5, variable 2 plus plus. Print the value of variable 1 and variable 2 plus plus.
Yes. Try to analyze this. Two variables are declared. Variables are initialized with 10 and 6. Just go through the instruction. Try to analyze. Sumne avlu ble explain martidre yenu, you people are not concentrating these. And if block she has taken, variable 1 is assigned with some value. Please go through the instructions and how she got the answer C. Amrut? Okay, Arushi.
Here in if statement, they have assigned variable 1 with 5. Inside if statement, they have incremented the value of variable 2, that is 7. So we will print variable 1, that is 5, and variable 2 as 7. Yeah, since they have given variable 2 plus plus here, it is a post increment. So variable 2, that is 7, will be printed. 5 and 7, that is answer is C.
Arushi, I have doubt here.
Yes, ma'am.
See, if it is a conditional execution instruction, we cannot have inside the parenthesis, we cannot have assignment statement, no? We should have Boolean expression inside the if block. That Boolean expression, not if block, inside the if parenthesis is there, no? So we need to write a Boolean expression that should result in true or false. How can you have a assignment statement here? Variable 1 is equal to 5. 5 is assigned to variable 1.
I think we will get error, no, here. Alva, where are you anastilva? Nang ge gotaktila. Nang ge doubt ide. Aishwarya?
Yes, ma'am.
See that if inside the if block, if condition, it should be a Boolean expression, no? It should result in true or false. Can we
yes,
have
ma'am, either it should result in true or false. So we can't assign, I guess. Even once you should execute this and we should see. Usually okay, we'll use the assignment operators and we'll check the conditions there. In syntax also we'll write if in bracket we'll mention condition. Never we have used assignment there.
Uh-huh. Okay. Arushi, can you execute this program?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, we will get as 5 and 7.
You are getting output. What is the output?
5 and 7.
5 and 7. Okay, come back to the program. So, other students, please try to analyze this program. Okay. Because ನಾನು ಸಿ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮಿಂಗ್ ತಗೊಂಡಿಲ್ಲ ನಾವೇನು ಏನು ಕಲಿಯುವಾಗ ಕಲ್ತಿದ್ದು ಅಷ್ಟೇ ನೀವು ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಗೋ ಥ್ರೂ ದಿಸ್ ಅದರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಗೋ ಥ್ರೂ ದಿಸ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಸಿ ದ ಸಿಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುಫ್ ಯೂಶ್ವಲಿ ಯುಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಕಂಡೀಷನಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಪುಟ್ ದ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಪ್ಯಾರಾಂಥಸಿಸ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಬೂಲಿಯನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಇರಬೇಕು ಅಲ್ವಾ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟ್ರೂ ಆರ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್
ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಅಸೈನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಪರೇಟರ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇದು ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಟ್ರೂಗೆ ಇವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯುಯೇಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಿರುತ್ತೆ ಇರಿಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಅದೇನೇ ಟ್ರೂಗೆ ಇವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯುಯೇಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಇದೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ
ಸೊ
ಏನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇರುತ್ತೋ ಅದು ಅಸೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳುತ್ತೆ ಬಟ್ ಟ್ರೂ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಸೈನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಟ್ರೂ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ 5 ಅಸೈನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ನಮಗೆ
ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ಐಶ್ವರ್ಯ ರಿಯಲಿ ಐ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ನೌ ಸೊ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ we can have the assignment expression here 5 is assigned to variable 1 and it evaluates to true if variable 1 is assigned with 0 then it evaluates to false ha huh?
again illa mama if conditionally ene idrunu just adu true aage barutha adu antara true ne aagbeku condition antiddaga ithara enadru maadkobodu na
arushi once again execute this program by assigning variable 1 with 0 we'll see what output you will get
okay ma'am, 1 minute, ma'am.
Yes, Arushi, what happened? The screen is not visible. Nange tumbha chikkadu kaanisthide. Adike neevu enaayitu neeve heli.
Ma'am, adu run aagta illa ma'am, one nimisha.
Ma'am,
okay, no problem. You just try it out. Otherwise,
ma'am, execute maadodrinda window close aagilla ma'am, adakke execute aagta illa idu.
Arushi, Vinay heltidare nodu, yen heltidare Vinay? You are getting error.
06 barutta ma'am.
06 barutta ma'am.
Okay, and that means
in value assign madthivo adu print agutte.
Just come back. That means what happens to that if evaluates to true or false?
Always true irutha ma'am adu. Ine adrunu always true ne agutte. All value in assign martivo adu where one place ge print agutte.
Okay. So even though var one is assigned with zero, but if block evaluates to true only. Okay. So var two will be incremented. Okay, Arushi. So nange idu marthe hogitu. Inside the if block, we can take assignment statement also. We can assign some value with the variable, and that is always evaluates to true. Okay, still, how many programs are there, Arushi?
Ma'am, two programs.
You just finish up those two programs, then we can wind up the meeting.
Okay. Next question, what is the output of the following C code? Int a is equal to 1, if a minus minus, print true, if a plus plus a, print false, and we have to return the value 0. And shall I explain, ma'am?
Yes, Arushi.
Can I explain, ma'am?
Yes.
If a minus minus means if a is if 1, print true, it will print the value true. 1 minus minus, it will be 0. Here we have post decrementing, and so it will be equal to 0. If plus plus a, here pre-incrementing, so plus plus a means again the value will be 1. So if 1, it will again print a false. So both true and false will be printed.
Okay, this program is also interesting. So first time it is post increment. Before incrementing the value of a, we are printing true. And inside the second if block, it is pre-increment. So before we enter inside the if block, a will be incremented. So a 0 and it will be incremented to 1. So if block evaluates to true, so we print the false also. Oh yes, it is really, this program is also interesting. Okay, next
program, to get the output as hwi orea, what should be the condition inside the if statement? Inside the main function, int I, care s, how is your exam? They have given a string, how is your exam? For I is equal to 0, s of I not equal to null, I plus plus I. We have to put a condition inside the if statement to print the given output. So here, in order to print this given word, we have to use I percentage 2 is equal to 0. We have to assign this statement because h is there, and w next space is also counted as 1. Every second element is printed in this statement, that is h, w, i, next space, next o, next r,
next E and next A. So by using this modulus operator, we can get this required output.
Yes, Arushi, we understood. Yes, this program is really, it is also very interesting. So actually, ee tarad program nodirilla na usually so syllabus alli en irutho adu athwa simple programs. So we'll go we have gone through the simple programs, and this is simple program, but really all programs are very interesting programs. Okay, Arushi, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, so let's end this meeting. So coming Thursday, and just today is Tuesday, no, tomorrow Wednesday, day after tomorrow the placement activity will be there. Okay, so the your seniors are going to address you people. Actually I asked them to address today itself, but they were busy in some training, Nisha and Raghavendra. So Thursday they talk to you people. Okay, they share their experience with you people, and how they have prepared for the campus placements, initially what happened, initially I mean, so once they finish, once they had finished sixth semester, no, so how they were preparing for the campus placements and all. So these their experience they are going to share. Raghavendra, he placed for 3 companies, and Nisha, he placed for 1 company, and she is continuously, she is the topper in our branch for her batch. Okay, so they are going to address you people. Please be attend. Okay, okay, let's end this meeting. Thank you all. You can leave the meeting now.